chilling out with the crew in the schoolyard. Finding trouble, never looking too hard. Well, back at class, they never taught us this. Well, some things you gotta learn him this.
Hey, what's up, everyone? NeoCypher here, getting back to Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution. And as you can tell, we are within the final four duels of this season. And in terms of episodes, we have the Power Within, which we are still within Season 3. And I've already kind of read the synopsis on Wikipedia. I figure instead of just looking at the actual season list, or sorry, the list of all episodes, I would specifically look at the wiki for Season 3 to kind of get an idea of what's going on. Yeah, so Yubel was defeated, removed from Marcel's body, but now went into Jesse's body. Also, I love how Yubel's whole thing is, yeah, I can force you to fight your friend. We've kind of already fought Jesse once this duel anyways. But the question is, are we going to be facing off against the same deck, or are we going to be more focused on the Crystal Beasts? Actually, that does remind me also that this has something to do plot-wise with the Rainbow Dragon as well. So I don't think we have to deal with the Sacred Beast, just the Crystal Beast in Rainbow Dragon. So yeah, this is going to get entertaining. I will give GX credit. It saved all the incredibly frustratingly hard duels for the very end of the series. Like the last several duels have been pretty much where most of my losses have come from so far this season. Is it Neospace? Okay, what do we got? Jeez. Okay, what we got here? All Crystal Beast monsters on the field and in the graveyard become dark. If an ultimate Crystal monster attacks, negate the effects of the attack target during that battle. During damage calculation, if a Crystal Beast monster you control battles and you will take damage, you can send one Crystal Beast monster from your deck to your graveyard and you take no damage from that battle. Ouch. So, instant Neospace. Equip only to a fusion monster or list elemental hero Neos as a material. It does not have to activate its effect during the end phase. Okay. So, basically, it's kind of like Neospace, only as an equip spell instead of a field spell. Fake Cures lets me special summon an elemental hero monster, but it can't attack, returns my hand during the end phase. Actually. Do I have anything that needs Aqua Dolphin? Not plus air hummingbird is not going to help. Neospatian Grand Mole. Clear Scarab. Yeah, I could do Elemental Hero Aqua Neos. Return, you can discard one card, or one random card in the opponent's hand. Okay. So, I'm probably going to regret doing a lot of this, but we're going to see where this goes. So we're going to get Elemental Hero Neos. What the heck is that? Oh. This card is treated as a normal monster while face up on the field or in the graveyard. While this card is a normal monster on the field, you can normal summon it to have it become an effect monster of this effect. This card's name becomes Elemental Hero Neos while on the field. Wait, what? This card is treated as a normal monster while face up on the field or in the graveyard. While this card is a normal monster on the field, you can normal summon it to have it become an effect monster with this effect. Okay. So I have to normal summon it, and then while it's already been normal summoned, I can then special summon it. Oh no. So I normal summon it on the field, and then during the next turn, when I can get another normal summon, I can have it become an effect monster that counts as Elemental Hero Neos. I'm just going to take the actual Elemental Hero Neos for this. Alright. Yep, so I need Spacian Aqua Dolphin. I can discard one card. Look at the opponent's hand, choose one monster. If I control a monster with an attack greater than or equal to the attack of the chosen card, destroy the chosen card. If I do, they take 500 damage. If not, I take 500 damage. No, instead, we are going to go ahead and play Fake Hero. Then we can go and special summon Aqua Neos. Play instant Neospace. Gonna activate its effect. Let's go ahead and discard Fake Hero. Actually, that's good. If I can get rid of Crystal Beasts, that's great. So basically, the goal is to try to keep his hand empty and new. But I want to keep instant Neospace in case he finds a way to... Well, even if he gets rid of it, my Aqua Neos is gone. I'm okay with him getting another field spell. I mean, he gets another card in his hand. Okay, this is going to be a bit of a risk, but we're going to go for it. Activate effect. Let's go and get Neos out of my hand, because I'm sure I have ways I can bring that back. Is that only once per turn? Yep, once per turn. So basically, my goal is to try to keep his hand empty as possible. Discard one card, fusion summon one fusion monster from your extra deck. From either field as fusion material. Not bad. But he's got nothing on the field I'm going to need for fusion. Okay. Okay. Wanna keep that instant Neo space just in case I need it. You know what? We're gonna activate this just in case. It also gives me some more attack, so I don't quite need this right now. So now it's all gonna come. So now both of our hands are empty. It's all gonna come down to what we draw. Nothing he can do. And actually, I should be able to pull this off. All I got's Neos. Yep, that's it. See, sometimes the risky plays at the start actually do pay off. So getting Aqua Neos out at the very beginning was actually a pretty good move. I'm surprised. Sometimes my risky moves don't play out. So yes, Jaden again defeats Yubel, and Jesse's been freed. Super polymerization. I can't even remember what that does. Alright, so we've unlocked the next campaign duel, Return of the Supreme King. Now the reverse duel for the Power Within. The Dark Rainbow deck recipe. Rainbow Dark Dragon, Crystal Release, Rare Value. And 1,422 victory duel points. I've got 100 points for the win, 20 for number of turns, 10 for winning without taking damage, 10 for spells, 15 for no traps, 6 for controlling a monster with high attack, 12 for maximum damage inflicted, 32 for difference of life points, and 10 for inflicting battle damage only. So yes, the next duel we have up is going to be Return of the Supreme King, which, looking at the episode list, we have two more duels after this. I know what the last duel is, but Return of the Supreme King is the last, well, it's a three-parter, but they're the last episodes to actually be dubbed in English. So I don't know what that duel is going to end up being, but given what the description for the final actual episode for Season 3 is, I'm guessing this is part of Season 4. And before I stop, though, I'm really curious what super polymerization does. Someone look that up real quick and completely mistype. Alright, super polymerization. Oh, that was the... I didn't even pay attention to the card name. That one fusion card I discarded, the discard one card, fusion summon one fusion monster from your extra deck using monsters from either field as fusion material. That was super polymerization. I didn't even pay attention to the card title. So, yeah, not sure. I might have to go back and actually watch that. Or watch the Power Within in the series. Because I have no idea how super polymerization would have been used in that duel. I honestly don't. Unless I somehow... Well, no, Rainbow Dragon's not even a fusion monster. Yep, no idea. So with that's all I've got for this video. Hope you guys are enjoying the project so far. I thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.
Game on, catch the game.